I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We'll need to tell the team what to redevelop via the R&D screen.
Clear the garage, please. Car's ready to leave. Going down the order, you're now in P7. Got one lap of fuel remaining. Expect to see some rain about 10 to 15 minutes from now. Green.
We're all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who'll be fronting the grid. Sainz, Hamilton, and Charles Leclerc. With qualifying complete, all that remains now is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then. Montreal is not only the second largest French-speaking city in the world, but it's home since 1978 to the Canadian Grand Prix. The name Villeneuve looms large over this one, but who can write their own legends today? It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. An immense lap from Carlos Sainz yesterday puts him in pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Norris, Oscar Piastri, Russell, Verstappen, Gasly, Tsunoda, Perez, Ace, Albon, Magnussen, Joe, Ricciardo, Bottas, Hülkenberg, Stroll, Ocon, and Logan Sargeant. And now it's time to head down to the track. And a warm welcome to Natalie Pinkham, who's beside me in the commentary box today. Let's talk about Ace. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, they've been avoiding mistakes and have had solid pace, so it's been a good season so far. But whether they can keep that up long term remains to be seen.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going. Okay, so our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of this lap. Okay, radar is clear, weather is looking good for now. Superb parking there, mate. Let's make sure we get the edge on the surrounding drivers as the lights go out. Okay, the start was fine. Let's try and move forward. Enabled this lap. You can use it when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Keep an eye on that gap ahead, please. 4.3 seconds. Teammate by 7.2 seconds.
Okay, focus. We need to stay on form. Okay, here's the gap that we're trailing the car ahead by. 7.4 seconds. Okay, gap to the car ahead is 10.5 seconds.
Piastri is in the pits. Okay, we're approaching the pit window. You're going to be on softs. Okay, let's calm down a bit out there. Let's keep these passes clean so we don't end up with a penalty, okay? Carlos is in the pits. Okay, off we go, back into the race. That was a fantastic stop, faster than we were expecting. That was our last stop, no more scheduled pit stops, let's go. Nice work, mate. That brings you up a place.
Understood. Stopping this lap. Our gap to the car in front is 13.6 seconds. That stop was slower than we ideally wanted to see. Gap ahead is 37.2 seconds.
front is 33.2 seconds. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left. Okay, so the gap to the car ahead, 29.0 seconds. Blue flag, blue flag. Right, we've got enough fuel for 3 more laps. All right, race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
That's it for another Grand Prix and a fantastic win for Mercedes. So, Natalie, what do you think helped them deliver this result?
I feel consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalise on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. Let's have a quick look at how the driver's standings have changed. It's a great result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Well, for me, it's got to be Lewis Hamilton. The multiple world champion may be the obvious choice at this point, but he's certainly a driver deserving of his great reputation.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes move to the top of the table. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time out. Be sure to join us once again as we continue to bring you all the excitement of Formula One.